Welcome to the Eyes on the Sky series, an update about current astronomy, space science, and sky events. I'm astronomer Richard Monda, and this is Eyes on the Sky for January 27th through February 29th, 2020. The last Monday in January starts with a thin lunar crescent in the southwestern evening sky. It's directly under the bright planet Venus and well to the upper left of Mercury. By the next evening, the lunar crescent has moved so that it's positioned slightly to the upper left of Venus. Venus becomes visible each evening higher in the sky through late March. Its altitude at first visibility decreases in April and then rapidly declines throughout the month of May. Watch this planet through a telescope and you'll see Venus go from gibbous to crescent phase as it orbits the Sun. On February 1st, the Moon is first quarter at 8:42 p.m. By the 2nd, the now waxing gibbous moon is among the stars of Taurus the Bull and found to the lower right of the Pleiades star cluster. On the evening of February 3rd, the moon is near the stars of the Bull's face and slightly above the star Aldebaran. On the 4th, the 75% lit moon is nearing the star Zeta Tauri, the tip of the Bull's lower horn. This star helps us locate an object called the Crab Nebula, the remnant of a supernova explosion that happened almost 1,000 years ago. Below Taurus is the constellation Orion the Hunter. Marking the Hunter's right shoulder is the bright star Betelgeuse. Last December, Betelgeuse underwent an unusual dimming. It went from being the ninth brightest star of the night sky to the 23rd brightest and has become dimmer than Aldebaran. Betelgeuse is a red supergiant, so large that it would extend beyond the inner solar system and almost to Jupiter. This star is expected to explode as a supernova, but not for another 100,000 years. On February 5th, the waxing gibbous moon, now 11 days past new, is east of the Bull's horns. By the 8th, the moon is approaching the leading side of Leo the Lion, and on the 9th, the full moon is near Regulus, the star that represents the lion's heart. The next night, the 17-day-old waning gibbous moon is under the hindquarters of the lion. By February 11th, the moon is rising just about 3 hours after sunset, when it is below Denebola, the lion's tail. Third or last quarter moon happens on February 15th as the moon approaches Scorpius in the morning sky. At dawn the next day, the waning crescent is next to the star Beta Scorpii. Then the thinning lunar crescent makes its way towards Sagittarius. So that on the 18th, the moon is very close to Mars. That day, the moon will cover Mars in an event called a lunar occultation. Before sunrise on February 19th, the 26-day-old moon is alongside the stars that make the handle of the Sagittarius teapot, and also next to Jupiter. Then on the 20th, the thin lunar crescent, less than 10% lit, appears near the horizon and next to Saturn. New moon occurs at 10:32 a.m. on February 23rd. 2 days later, there's an ultra-thin lunar crescent far below Venus in the evening twilight. By the 26th, the crescent moon is easy to view in the west-southwest when it is again below Venus. The following evening, the lunar crescent makes a stunning sight alongside this bright planet. On February 28th, the waxing crescent is across from the faint constellation of Aries the Ram. Finally, on leap day, the moon is in the northern section of Aries when it's 2 days before first quarter. I'm Hudson Valley Community College astronomer Richard Monda, reminding you to keep your eyes on the sky.